you look back over your spiritual life, what moments do you recall when you felt especially close to God? Most of us have those moments of spiritual clarity when we feel at one with all of God and creation. You know, those moments we call mountaintop experiences. And of course, when that happens, we just want to stay there on the mountaintop, reveling in that experience of closeness with God. But of course, we can't. Life moves on, and we have to move on with it. Back when I was in college, I had a friend who suddenly got religion, as they say. You know what I'm talking about. He wasn't just on the mountaintop. He was on top of the world. Everything was right with the world. Everything was right with him. He was very zealous with his newfound faith. As I remember it, his euphoria lasted about 2 weeks. And then he discovered, as we all do, that life indeed goes on. You simply can't stay at that peak. The challenges and demands of life reappear, and they're just as daunting as they ever were. As my friend discovered, having that mountaintop experience doesn't mean the valleys are not still there. We come down from that mountain, and there they are, the valleys. Life for my friend resumed with the same temptations, challenges, pressures, and worries. I remember his disappointment in that. The challenge he faced then, as we all do, was, okay, does that mean none of that euphoria was real? Does that mean it was kind of all in my head and I was just overreacting? I remember how he had to work through that, and eventually he did. In fact, he later became a pastor. What made this whole thing so difficult for him was he wanted that mountaintop experience to last. He thought that having that intense religious experience meant his life would be that way from then on. And in a sense, I think that's partly true, at least to some degree. We're changed by those experiences. They provide something that we can carry back into the valleys to help sustain us through the challenges and perils of our lives. Well, this Sunday is Transfiguration Sunday. And this contrast between the peaks and the valleys is exactly what you see in the Transfiguration story that we find in the Gospel of Luke. So, as we wrap up our Epiphany worship series, we'll consider together how our mountaintop experiences can energize, nourish, and help us in the living of our lives in between the peaks. I look forward to delving into this idea further with you this Sunday in the sanctuary.